Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. For today's video, guys, I'm gonna show you a little technique of one pass, root and cap all in one pass. A little example here on an inch and a half pipe, sked 40. And this is how the final product looks like. Just a little bit touch up makeup and it's gonna be nice and ready for QC inspection. Couple things I'm gonna show you in this video, guys. First of all, steps how to get to that point and why. There's a pros and cons. There's a more pros. Why not to go with a regular procedure? Okay, for example, prep as usual, clean inside, outside. Try to make a bevel a little bit different angle. Not that wide, less. If you got less that narrow bevel, it's gonna be easier for you to put that root in. And for the gap, you wanna have minimum gap here. You want like 16 of an inch for a gap. And we're gonna put 3 tacks on 3, 6, and 9 o'clock. It's gonna be a little tiny root tacks, just to hold that pipe in place. For this video, right now I'm tacking with a 70S2, but for the root, for the one pass, I'm gonna use a 1/8 rod, 70S6. The amps, I'm gonna go with a 130 amps. And this is how it should look like. There's a 3 tacks, it's not even bevel, and it doesn't have to be. This is one of the benefits of doing one pass. It doesn't have to be perfect. You can have a high low, you can have a little bit misalignment and an uneven gap. That one pass is gonna cover all that. I'm just gonna feather out those tacks and it should be good. Okay, this is one example of a regular procedure. This is 3/32 gap. This is what we do usually, and or majority of welders, especially in the field. The time we put a root, and even some guys didn't even go hard passing this. I don't see a need for that, but I'm gonna show anyway how we do it usually. That's procedure, and finish it with a 2-pass cap. So this is one of the cons doing regular procedure. You gotta fit the time you spend putting that root. You can be done with all that weld in less than 5 minutes. Especially on small stuff like that, sometimes it's open and then you have an uneven root. It's all wavy, or you gotta build up on some spots. Especially now this is horizontal, so it might sag down on you, or you can have a whatever, some grapes on the bottom side of the weld. You don't want that. I even seen some guys doing a hot pass, and definitely there's no need for that. Eventually you can do maybe 1/8 and start capping with 1/8. As you see, the root is not perfect, and then you gotta go 2-pass on a cap. Also waste of time. I mean, guys, lots of times, especially in the field, there's not much room, there's not much place, you can barely put your head in, and then you gotta go around 3 or 4 times around the pipe. I'm not saying there's sometimes, especially if you do closure weld, yeah, you have to go, you have to follow WPS. As you can see here, I did this cap intentionally. As I said, now we gotta go all the way around three times, even 4 times sometimes. I mean, also depends from the thickness of the pipe, but actually no need, so we're just gonna get rid of that. Okay, now we're gonna continue. I'm gonna show you one pass motion, up and down, side to side. I'm gonna stretch that paddle, keeping both edges, try to keep it even. Once you strike an arc, place that rod. And right below. So once when it starts preheat, reach that temperature, it's just gonna start pushing that material inside. So you're gonna have a good root, and then just all the most important thing here is adjust your travel speed. And there's a couple things to be coordinated, you know, adding that wire, travel speed, going up and down with the motion, and can try to keep that weld puddle some kind of nice and uniform shape for the final appearance. I forgot to mention, so I stopped two times. It'll be ideal if you can go all the way around without stopping. And just grind stop starts. That is the thing I forgot to mention. It'll be easier just to make a nice blade on the tie-ins. Nice smooth tie-in. As I said, one of the things that really saves you time and energy, especially in your field, just going two, three, four times around, there's lots of work sometimes, guys, on as you majority know that there's lots of work around 1 inch, 2 inch, the time you set up, the time you weld, all that thing, it's just exhausting. It's easier sometimes to weld 10 inch and above than a small pipes. And this is how it should look like. Then we're gonna do a couple touch-ups. I like to run file on both sides of the bead and just grind that button. It's a little bit saggy as I'm finished. I got that little crater. I got a crater, the main reason is just the TIG torch I'm using. It's nothing fancy, that's why I gotta do hard pull, so usually that's what that creates that crater at the end. Just a hand brush and just to clean all that. And this is how it should look like. I'm just gonna show you the root now. And this is what you get for your root. You got a nice perfect ring inside. As I said, that's why I like one pass. Just want to tell you guys, when I was back in, when I work back in Europe, when I was in Germany for 5 years, this is what we did on a regular daily basis pretty much. We would get to that point, we were just running over 200 amps, doing stuff like that, and everything was x-rayed and it was not failure, nothing. I had never had any issue with the one pass welds. Since I've been here in Canada, we don't do that much here. And yeah, as I said, this is touch up and this is how it should look like. I'm just gonna show you one more example, guys. Even for bigger pipes, a little bit bigger pipes, you can do that as well. It's just gonna save you time and energy. And once you dial in, like for everything, you need practice. It's all about practice. Okay, right now I got a 3-inch SCAD 40. Same thing, same prep. As you can see, tiny tacks just to keep that pipe in place, just to hold. For this bigger pipe, just gonna use a 532 70S6. And 185 amps, this is what I'm using for this pipe. 180 amps, same thing. Once you strike an arc, push that rod right in below that tungsten, and keep an eye so it doesn't open on you. It's a little bit, it's a bigger pipe with a bigger rod, it's a little bit more demanding. It requires a little bit more effort to weld. But it's the same idea, same thing. Keep an eye on the top and the bottom of the weld puddle. Keep an eye on the root. Try to have your sharp tungsten always. And a nice good hot amperage is just pushing that material inside, so you're gonna have a nice and good looking root. I just wanna give you guys an idea, and you know, something. If you didn't try it, try it. As I said, it's gonna save you lots of time and energy, especially out in the field. For me, honestly, this is one of the things I really don't like to do. Small spaghetti stuff. But sometimes we have to do it, so. And that's the root. As I said, root's looking good. With that one pass, nothing's wrong. And this is the final, how it looks from the outside. Got a couple arc strikes, but I was too shaky. And yeah, just gotta do a little touch up, grind that button, as the weld itself, it's a horizontal, so it sags down a little bit. You don't wanna sag too much. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed, learned something new. Hope I gave you some good ideas for practice. Thank you for your support so far, and see you in the next one. Take care.